Hi, I'm Dustin Berg with Pro AV School, and with me today is my friend, Gus de Beauville, and he is here to talk about the new course that he's actually produced in the last, about 6 months or so that you've released it?
Well, I actually released it only about a month ago. It took about 3 months of filming and development and editing, but I think it just went live the middle of June.
Okay. I jumped into that. Sorry, I should say the course is about audiovisual installation. So I know I talk a lot on this channel about programming, and I'm actually actively working to kind of shift the programming stuff to a different channel so that I can focus on more general AV stuff. And this call and this video is about Gus's course regarding AV installation. Let's get on topic here and let's talk about your course. What does it cover? What are you teaching people?
Okay, so first thing, what I want to convey is that there are multiple different areas of expertise in AV, in the audiovisual industry, right? So we have to have people in every department, and they all come together cohesively to make things happen. So you have your sales guys, you have your managers, you have your designers, you have your installers, you have your programmers. And I just chose to specialize instead of being a generalist meandering through life. I realized early on I was good at installing things, being on site, solving problems, building things. I really enjoy the act of showing up with a blank canvas, say a new construction, and we build things from the ground up. That's what we like to do. But I find that there isn't a lot of awareness in terms of AV installation as a trade, as just being a technician. People stumble into it, as I said before, and either they sink or swim. So for me, I wanted to help bring some awareness to installation as a trade in general. And I looked around for different options, educational options for myself and for new hires, because, I could basically, I'm preaching to the choir. The traditional way of learning to be an AV installer is to show up, zero experience, shadowing, being the helper, being the guy that just is the gopher, as you would refer to them up here. And that takes a lot of time and effort, and it grinds some people down because guys just don't like to be considered the noob on site or the junior. Yeah. People feel intimidated by that, right? Going to a construction site and never having any experience. It's kind of like the law of the jungle. You know, we can sense people that don't know what they're doing. And I wanted to help change that. I wanted to provide individuals some education on our trade and on our industry, but provide them with the skill sets, the knowledge, the experience, the exposure to take away some of those fears and help them be useful immediately.
Yeah, if you're an electrician, for example, which is sort of a similar area that we're the space that we're in.
Sure.
There's trade school, and you take an apprenticeship, and you take some schooling, then you show up on site, and you actually at least know something. Maybe you start on site as an apprentice first. I actually don't know, but I do have a friend that's an electrician. I should have asked him this question. That would have been probably relevant. But I know that
electricians all the time. You know that.
Yeah, well, there's definitely some stuff where you go to school and you take some stuff. So you don't end up as totally blank and not knowing what to do. Whereas AV, you kind of fall in that trap sometimes. It depends on the team that you're with. It depends on how willing your company is to train you. Depending how willing the techs that you're working with are to stop and show you stuff. And there's not a ton of options out there for kind of a comprehensive training for people that are getting started or looking into AV. And I think that's kind of the area where your course is filling a gap.
Well, I'm trying. I think the way that things are strategic, because the more mysterious, the more difficult or technically sort of unattainable something is, I think the more expensive it can become. But the flip side of that and the disadvantage of keeping everyone behind closed doors is that we are not encouraging new traffic into our industry in terms of young, vibrant people that are needed, right? Like a lot of the guys that I work with, I'm the young guy and I just turned 41. You know what I mean? So we need to help usher in a new sort of dynamic where guys that are now finished trade school, guys and gals, because I've seen some fairly competent female electricians, but not many AV. I mean, in 15 years, maybe I've seen two female AV technicians and they were good, but that's not a good statistic that we should be proud of. We should be way more inclusive, way more encouraging, because the truth is there is so much opportunity for young individuals who have just the entry point is so low because it's not yet been developed into a full-fledged unionized trade, like plumbers, gas fitters, electricians, you name it. They all have this 4-year process before they can officially call themselves a full-fledged trade person. But with AV, you can essentially have zero experience and call yourself an AV technician from day one. Hey, I'm a junior tech. Not only that, a lot of people don't realize that the entry point salary is still fairly high compared to a lot of other non-skilled jobs. Yep. So we need to educate the workforce. AV is a really good career path. It pays well. Not only that, it's constantly growing. You're not working with the same materials, the same products continually. Like, you know, I remember when we first started with VGA technology, BNCs, and that's gone. You know, composite video, component video. I mean, we're getting to the point where technology is essentially virtual reality, augmented reality, and all of these interesting, amazing things have to be installed by someone.
Yeah. Yeah, so we're definitely seeing things where traditional AV companies and integrators would handle everything, and that's kind of been sectioned off. I think some end users, obviously universities and colleges and stuff like that, will handle a lot of the stuff themselves. We're seeing big institutions like banks and stuff where sometimes they have a whole department that kind of just handles AV. There's still opportunity for guys and gals to get in kind of almost at the ground floor as an installer and start maybe working for an organization that's not an AV dealer. And getting into something like that, it helps. It definitely helps to have some sort of experience with the industry. And if you're coming into it with nothing or not even knowing that it exists, a course like yours can kind of be a good kind of prep, sort of an introduction to a world that maybe you didn't really fully understand what was all there, or that you do know about it, but you've never really done it or never really set foot onto an AV installation site. Going through your course will help people to kind of not be as apprehensive about getting into it.
Don't be afraid. People just don't want to look stupid, you know, even. Yeah. Haven't been involved in the industry for this long, I see it all the time. People are shamed for asking specific questions. People are sort of denigrated for doing things a certain way. And
yeah. Well, can I stop you for a second?
Yeah.
I just thought like some of these online communities, the AV industry is, we're pretty good at being the camaraderie and stuff between people. Like if you ask good questions, you usually get a bunch of guys that have good answers, a bunch of people that have answers. But if you ask questions that people think are stupid, the internet mindset is to just jump and pounce on people. And sometimes it's scary, right? You don't want to ask those questions kind of in the general public because people will think you're an idiot or they'll treat you like you're an idiot when all you just don't really understand what you're actually trying to ask.
And just bear in mind that I see things from behind the gated community of working on construction sites, live construction zones where you're expected to carry yourself a certain way. You have to be tough. You can't just come in there loosey-goosey and create a scene. Or, you know, on live construction sites, you have to conduct yourself safely and professionally. And individuals that don't do that are corrected immediately by the hive mentality. So I can appreciate, even myself, every new project, you go in there with this air of, hey, let's put our best foot forward. It is concerning. So I fully agree that someone who's never done this before would be hell of intimidated to go into an orientation with 20 people all wearing construction gear, dealing with superintendents, making sure that they have the correct PPE, they understand what hazard assessment safety forms are. You know, I'm just trying to prepare people so that they don't fail coming out of the gates. Yeah. They feel confident, they feel comfortable, and they can be useful. Because let's be honest, every trade, you can't just read a book and call yourself a tradesperson. You need to get hands-on experience. And new hires have to know that you can't have all the answers. But there is a specific way to conduct yourself to demonstrate that this guy has a good head on his shoulders. He is not going to be erratic and he will not be a liability to me, right? He's not going to show up with the wrong attitude so that it will be a pleasure to bring him underneath our mentorship and help him sort of progress. And that is what I want. I want to train people the right way from day one.
Yeah. Well, a lot of this stuff, you can't really Google it. You can Google and search on YouTube and stuff for specific tasks. You don't know where they're coming from. You don't know if the information that you're getting is good. And you don't really know what the next thing you should learn is. I think with your course, you've assembled a bunch of videos that basically go through a whole bunch of different things that you would experience on a typical installation. I know you've got some stuff in there about mounting displays to different kinds of walls and stuff. I think that was actually my suggestion. but like, it's hard to research that stuff. It's probably a little bit easier now. When I was doing installations, there was nothing. Like that was pre-internet. So maybe I don't quite have the most current knowledge in terms of installs, but I still think that it's hard to really Google and search for this information that gives you a comprehensive understanding. And like your course, it's not super expensive. I think the price to just like not look like an idiot and have a little bit of back-end knowledge is well worth it. If you know somebody that's like getting into the industry or interested in the industry or working in a different area that you think, you know, AV install might be a good thing for you, I think your course is a very, very low friction way to get kind of on board with what's going on, to even just to experience what it is to be an AV installation technician.
Well, I appreciate that. Thank you. It was priced deliberately so it would be accessible to anyone that is considering this, right? I've taken very expensive courses and I've taken quite inexpensive courses, you name it, on the different platforms that exist. And I will say, you know, sometimes you get what you pay for. Therefore, that's why it's sort of perceived as better value if the more expensive it is. And there's more accountability for it. So that's one thing why I didn't price it any cheaper. Because if you start working as an AV tech, you can pay for this course in one day. But moving forward, that course would have secured your position in that company to earn a living, to open the doors and just get hired and demonstrate, hey, this guy, he seems to be on point versus someone who just showed up empty-handed, right? I've dealt with new hires that didn't even know what a screwdriver was or a drill. So that's why I specifically created and crafted the course to take someone with zero experience. You have to show up with an empty cup in order to be teachable. If you know everything, then why aren't you in the job already, right?
Yeah.
So it's meant to be really thorough in terms of providing you with all of the foundational skills.
And can I just stop you for one second? Because I just realized as you're talking, I didn't want to make this sound like it was a late night infomercial. So I was trying to avoid like price. But we talked about the price. If anybody's actually interested in this course, they're thinking like, what is the price? You keep talking about the price. What's the price?
It's on the website. It starts at $97. And for $97, you go through, it'll take you about 6 hours, but it'll break down the process and the definitions of what we do. So imagine you know nothing. By the end of the course, you will know what our focus is, what our industry is, what equipment we use, what tools we use, what tasks we have to carry out, different cables, different processes like making cables and testing them, and soldering, mounting TVs on walls, using safety equipment, safety forms, just a couple of personal things that I have implemented into my workflow that work for me, and especially liability. So by liability, I mean, don't break anything, don't break yourself, don't hurt yourself. And I think that in itself is worth the price of admission.
But for sure. Yeah, that's good value. Like I was trying to think of what else is $97. I couldn't think of anything. I thought maybe
get you a job. It'll get you a job that isn't a dead end job, you know?
Yeah. Well, I mean, a phone, like how much do we spend on our phones? Like my phone plan is like $100 and some odd a month. The phone itself, I don't know, it's like 800 to $1,000, but
well, you want to know some honesty. The reason I kind of built the course is because I have a hard time finding good entry level guys. It's they don't know. No one knows about AV. And then when they do know and they come and show up, they have no tools. They don't even have like a screwdriver. I wanted to create something that I can get my junior technicians to watch, so that when they show up on site, half of the day isn't spent going, this is 18-2, this is a box of cable, this is a safety vest, you need to wear these safety boots. What's it, you know what I mean? Like just get them up to speed so that they can be useful from day one.
Right, and it's a reference that they can go back to and watch later too, right?
The thing about it is like, now that all of the work is done and the course is online, not only do you have access to it whenever you need it, depending on, say, tomorrow I gotta pull cable. So then you pull up that particular module and go through the cables that we use most. Say tomorrow we have to mount a TV, you know, go through that module. But the beautiful thing about it is like anytime I encounter something in the field that I think is important, I add it to the course. So it's constantly building. Recently, I was doing some remote work and a programmer had to take over my computer from a different site.
I do that all the time, but I'll let you talk about it from the kind of the installer's perspective.
So from the installer's perspective, I wanted to get guys familiar with some of these processes. So, you know, change in DNS settings, setting up your computer so that it can be used remotely, just making guys aware of all the different aspects that we encounter so that they're not caught off guard. What do you mean I need a computer? What are you talking about? Well, you need a laptop sometimes if you want to patch into a processor. How do you patch in? Well, we need a USB cable or we need a router. And this is how you change an IP address. That'll be a specific module, which I think you actually helped collaborate on that one. So I think I want to include that in the course. Yeah. It's a little bit more technical. It's something that a lot of people don't even realize we have to do. There is a networking component to modern AV. We have audio. We have 128 channels of audio going through one network cable. People don't know that. We need to bring them up to speed. And not in a way that it's like specific to this particular manufacturer of gear. We just need general knowledge and more advanced, competent techs.
Yeah, I agree. And I think everybody in the industry can agree that attracting new talent and bringing new people into the folds of AV is something that really needs to happen, because a lot of AV guys are old guys, right? Like, we're not
demographics. There's websites that break down the demographics and the average age of AV techs, and it was scary. I think it was like 50.
Wow.
50, yeah, is the median, and it predicts that there's going to be, because AV is growing exponentially, it almost doubles in the amount of like equipment and requirements, but the attraction of new manpower is dismal, and it's going to create some problems. No one's talking about this. And I think if I'm allowed to quote specific references, take a look at Commercial Integrator magazine. They're based out of Europe from what I can remember, and they discussed it. It seems to be a growing impending wave of extreme lack of people to work this industry. So why not? Why can't we help develop it? And because of the internet, we're not just focusing on our local market. We're helping people. I take a look at the analytics of the website, and so far we have been getting interest from United States, Canada. I saw some South American action there. And I was really like, I think China as well. Now, I predicted that this was going to happen, so I sort of started incorporating closed caption and transcripts. Now, I plan in the future to add different languages, but for inclusivity and people that maybe have disabilities for hearing or whatever, I wanted to make sure that everyone got their fair share at this.
Yeah. Cool. Well, I think we've probably talked about it enough for now. Maybe we'll have some more videos and go through it a bit more, but just to wrap up this one anyways, where can people go to find out more about the course? We'll put a link below the video as well. Sure. Or with the video, depending on where it ends up. It's going to be on YouTube, and we'll see where else we end up posting it, but go ahead.
coreav.ca. coreav.ca.
All right. Okay. Well, thanks, Gus, for coming on today, having a little chat. We'd probably do it together if we didn't have still the COVID restrictions, but that'll be lifting soon, I think.
No, man. It's always nice to hear from you. I appreciate the chat.
Yeah, it's been good. So good luck on your course. And I hope that people that are the relevant audience for this, I know a lot of people that listen to my stuff are more programmer types, but maybe you guys know somebody, or know somebody who's new in your organization that doesn't really know much about installs. And sometimes programmers know, like me, I know a bit more than I should about installations, but I also don't really have time to teach guys how to do installs. And it's been a while since I've been boots on the ground myself. So if I was kind of introduced to somebody that was new, I would say, hey, you know, check out this course, $97, like it's no brainer. the company would probably pay for it with no problem at all. I know I would have, if I was a, when I was an install manager, it would have been kind of just something that you could write off.
We want guys to make sure that they don't get injured in the field, as well as damage in equipment, because that can get expensive very quickly. And I've made an effort. And plus, there's one thing, when you have a new hire, as soon as they put on that uniform, they're representing the entire company. So you want people to represent you in the most professional way possible, so that there's a positive feedback loop with your clients. Hey, that guy came here and it was like a breath of fresh air. You know, they put, you know, I don't even want to go through all the different procedures that I did, but with your permission, I love the scope of your net with Pro AV School. And if you want, I can start introducing some of your student body to the installation side of things. I can pop by whenever you have some time to focus on that and just build up the installer demographics a little bit. And I'll be more than happy to do that.
Yeah. Well, we also started that Pro AV School community on Facebook. And that's a place where Gus is also active and myself. So it's a good place to ask questions and stuff. And for install, definitely check out Gus's course, coreav.ca. So thanks everybody for checking out this video. And if you like this channel, we're going to be focusing more on kind of general AV stuff. So go ahead and subscribe so that you have more notifications or whatever of of new videos as they come out. I got to be a better YouTube guy. I got to put more content out. I think the last video was a long time ago.
Viewers, take some time and just listen to your viewers and ask them, what exactly would you like us to focus on? Because that's the best way to deliver the most bang for your buck, is to give the people what they want as opposed to what you think.
Yeah. All right. Well, thanks everybody. And we'll see you in the next video.
Thank you, Dustin.